So we're just not even gonna do one. When I posted on my Instagram that I was going to be doing like my YouTube channel, I got a lot of people saying that they wanted me to do like a makeup type of thing, and I'm not gonna do like a tutorial, but I bought us tickets to go see a band called Issues forever ago. I am so excited. I have been wanting to see this band with my husband for 3 years, so I'm gonna be doing my makeup and kind of just talking through it. Okay, yeah, this is also like a very vulnerable, I guess, like moment for me, because I never like post pictures without makeup on or like Snapchats or anything without makeup on. So right now I'm doing this, my first video, is a lot for me, but we're just gonna deal with it and move on, because that's just what we're gonna do. If you don't know this about me already, I live and breathe for Jeffree Star. Like, I can't even begin to tell you like how much money I have invested into like his brand. And there's still so many things that I want to get that I don't have. Obviously, I bought the Conspiracy Collection. I also bought the chapstick, which I have really enjoyed. I'm trying to get better at using chapstick because I wear a liquid lipstick a lot. And like 99% of the time, the liquid lipstick I'm wearing is Jeffree's. So it's not like they're super drying, because they're not. But like, I still need to put chapstick on before I use a liquid lip, just because it just makes them last longer and feel better. Right now, I've been experimenting a lot with drugstore, like drugstore makeup, because I've heard so many good things about the products that I'm going to be using. And honestly, like, they're helping me so much. Like, I love them, and they're doing wonders for my oily skin, so yeah. But I am gonna go in first with the Laura Mercier oil-free primer, because it's just, it hits, you know, it hits. So I'm using it. Anyways, I was researching good drugstore foundations for oily skin, and one of the ones that I found is CoverGirl Outlast Active. It's a 24-hour foundation that has sunscreen in it as well. It's like winter time, so I don't necessarily need that, but you know, for the summer maybe. Anyways, I wear the shade 810 classic ivory, and I literally love it. Like, it's sweat proof, transfer proof, humidity proof. Like, it's literally everything that you could ask for, and it delivers. But I have quite a bit of redness. You can't really see it that much right now. So I got this CC cream in one of my Ipsy bags, and I've been using it before I put on my foundation, and I actually really enjoy what it does. So I'm gonna do that. Yeah, I'm just gonna go in with this on my face where I need it. I'm not using a concealer right now, just because honestly I ran out, and like I just haven't cared enough to go buy a new concealer. So I guess we're gonna, let's see. Oh, man. I recently got eyelash extensions. I got them for my wedding. I really like them. My eyelashes are like such an important part of my routine, like to begin with. And I always hated when I didn't have the time to put my falsies on, because I felt like it really took away from the look. So getting them done honestly saves me so much time, and like really has made me more comfortable without makeup on. I honestly was like so, my heart was like so full on like how many responses I got stating that people wanted me to do my makeup, because I love makeup so much. But I spent so much time researching and watching tutorials and whatever else. I'm like, I'm not the best. Like, I know that. But I've improved so much. And the fact that people think that my makeup is good enough that they want to watch me do it is, like, insane. And it's so cool. And it's just, I'm a humble girl, you know. This foundation is also very full coverage. And I live for a full coverage foundation. It's really nice. And, like, given that, like, I'm going to be going to a concert and probably, like, sweating and whatever with the interview at a freaking concert, it really helps. I will say though, I feel like this foundation, like the product itself, it comes with one fluid ounce, but I don't feel like that's a lot. Like, I don't know. Like, it might just be me being like a greedy ass, but like, I don't know. I just don't feel like it. It has a lot of product in the bottle itself. Okay, like that is good. So my face powder that I'm using is the Coty Airspun Boost Face Powder. One looks like this, the infamous Coty Airspun Face Powder. I was using the Laura Mercier one, and it's not that I didn't like it, I just was running out of it, and I was like, you know what, if I'm gonna do this whole drugstore thing, like, why not go the whole extra mile, you know? So, that's what I did. I will say that it doesn't, like, I have to tap it into the lid a few times before I can actually get like a good amount out that I am comfortable with. Also, I go in with my beauty blender and just pat it into my skin. And this is definitely what takes me the longest in my makeup routine because it does take me a while to get my whole face covered. So I'm probably gonna speed this part up a little bit just because it does take a long time. Cheeks, like she definitely has my cheeks. Like I have chubby ass cheeks, but like, you know,
it's okay. It's fine because I made a cute baby out of it. So
I really hope that I look back on this in like a few years and is like, you know what?
Good effort. Like great effort. I love
that for you. Because yeah, I definitely need to film like my next one in like the daytime because this is a struggle. So anyways, my bronzer. This is my, like, whatever that saying is, tried and true, like, whatever the hell. Ride or die, main bitch, like, this is it for me. I have been using this bronzer for, like, I don't even know how long, and it lasts me forever. Like, I can't remember the last time I had to buy this because, like, it
lasts so long.
It is the Tarte Amazonian Clay Matte Waterproof Bronzer in the shade Hotel Eris. It's just beautiful. Like, I cannot express enough, like, how pretty this shade is.
Like, truly.
I keep all my brushes separate from my actual makeup bag just because it's so much easier, and I have the Morphe X Jeffree Star brush holder, so I just have to use it. My husband got this brush set for me for my birthday last year, and it hits, I'm not gonna lie. Pretty much just hits the spot, you know? My bronzer brush, I don't use the Jeffree one, which is kind of funny, but I am using a Morphe brush. I've had this for so long that I don't know which one it is, but it looks like this. So we're just gonna do that. Depending on how I feel, honestly, look, like I've had this for like probably over a freaking year, and like this is how much I've used. Like, that's insane to me, truly. So I just go in pretty lightly and I just dab it a few times, and then I just like hit it, because if you use too much of it, I will say it's so pigmented that like it can look bad. But I have made that mistake many times already, so I know
how to avoid that.
You know, I'm just gonna try it, and if we don't like it, then we don't like it, you know? Oh my god, this is so better. I hate myself. I am so sorry for that. Gotta love starting out fresh, you know? Alright, so I'm gonna do my cheekbones now. Nope, gonna do my mirror. We never get to do anything, and like, okay, anyways, honestly, one side of my face always turns out so much better than the other, and it's very annoying. Like, one side's like, I'm trying to think of an analogy that's never been done before. One side's like Gucci, the other side's like Kmart. That's how I feel. Oh, is my hair drying now? I'm like, okay, we're done. Anyways. Now I'm gonna go in and just, I guess it's contouring my nose, but like, I don't like to call it contouring because I'm not trying to make my nose smaller, and honestly just because I'm not
the best at contouring.
But I do like putting bronzer on the sides of my nose just because I feel like it defines my nose more, and I enjoy that aspect of it. So yeah, I cannot believe how better this lighting is. I feel so stupid that I was like trying to do my makeup in the dark. Like.
Two things for my blush. The first one I do is I go in with the Sephora palette. It's just a Sephora blush palette, and I've had it for like 2 or 3 years,
and it hits, and it's been hitting for 2 or 3 years. So I go in with 2 shades. I go in with this shade right here and this shade right here. I mix them, and then I do my highlight, and I go in with a pink red. I'll just color that one again. I dab it on my cheeks. Ew, that looks super pretty today.
I really am enjoying that right now.
I found a dupe for the Urban Decay
Oil
Slick, I think that's what it's called, foundation. Setting spray, not foundation. And it's the e.l.f. Matte Magic Mist and Set. I have been using this for a week now, and it is amazing. And it's literally $5. Like, hello, are you kidding? I just swear by this shit. Like, it is so good. I would recommend it 110% to anybody that has oily skin or just like some matte finish, because it is beautiful and it does the exact same thing that the $30 setting spray does. Like, honestly, oh, I just am obsessed with it, and I think it's so cool that like we can go get a $5 setting spray that does the same exact thing that you know, like literally what I just said. Yeah, so once I do my blush, my bronzer and all that, I will spray my face. So we'll just do that real fast. And then I'll fill it. So it's like almost dry. Now I go in with, I take my Morphe X Jeffree Star in the brush JS4. That's the blush I use. This is the highlight I use. It's a technique,
I swear. I go in,
and I'm actually really sad because my highlighting color that I've been using is almost gone. I hit pan on it, and like,
I'm genuinely sad about it, to be honest. Anyways,
I go in with the Morphe X Jeffree Star palette, surprise, and I go in with shade Designer Label. It is this one right here. Oh, like, life-changing, I swear to god. This shade just does the job. Marcus's aunt Jessica got this for me for my birthday, and like, I was so like surprised, just because that is such a sweet thing to do, and like, they're not cheap. And so I was just like,
I was so excited for it. Like, honestly, I was living for her. I live for her every single day. Live and breathe Jessica. Like,
she is so good with her daughter, and she'll watch her for us overnight, like, if we need to, and she's just such a sweet person, and just, like, God, she's a saint. Truly. Hi, Tia, if you're watching. So I just go in and I tap this a few times. Oh, God, is this gonna work? And then I kind of just, like, feather it, like, Jeffrey recently said that he is coming out with a new highlighter, and he was like,
she's pricey. Like, it's fine, I'll still buy it anyway.
I'm really excited for it.
Because it's like a brand new formula, I believe.
And I'm really
excited about it.
He said it literally makes your skin look like
diamonds, and like, who doesn't need that, you know? Because I love that for me. Love it.
So I'll put it on just like right here, and then I'll smile and put it on like the apples of my cheeks. I'm literally like digging to get it off the palette because it's like almost on and it makes me bad. But the another really good highlight shade is the one that's in the
Charles X Morphe palette.
That one's a freaking gold mine too, like quite literally. Then I go in on the same palette and I just like lightly, like the lightest you've ever been though, like lightly, dab my brush into shade Calabasas, which is this cutie right here.
Hello, right there.
I very lightly tap it. I even tap it off again. And then I go in and just like barely put it on the apples of my cheeks. Lighting makes me look like a
freaking clown. I love that journey for me, honestly.
Oh, I'm just buffing this out a little bit because I can't tell if I actually look like this or if it's just the lighting. But I'm going in with Morphe X Jeffree Star JS1, just this buffing brush, just to make sure that I don't look clowny, you know. And then I usually will go in with like more of a highlight as well, just to kind of like cover up a little bit. I just really like how it makes my cheeks pop more, and I think the shade itself is so beautiful to use as
for this purpose. So
now let's have a conversation. I, again, not a beauty guru. Let me tell you one of the reasons why. My eyebrows are not my strong point. They've gotten a lot better, but like, they have their own lives. And I've just learned to accept that they have their own lives. So that's where we're at. I use the Tarte Amazonian Clay Waterproof Brow Mousse. I go in with my Morphe X Jeffree Star JS7 eyebrow brush.
I'm probably gonna do these
off camera just because it's a process for me, and yeah, it's
just, you know, where we're at.
Alright, I'll see you guys in a quick minute. I'm just gonna go do my eyebrows and I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. I don't know, I've always had a thing with my eyebrows, and like, I just didn't want to do them on camera, and just, you know, I just wanted to avoid it
completely, so that's what I did. And it was good timing because Violet came in
and needed to get her diaper changed,
and it's a whole production with her changing her diaper right now. She just for some reason thinks she doesn't need to wear them, so whenever we change her, she rolls around and tries to get out of it, and it's just this big thing. So I had to help Marcus with that. My hair is almost dry.
To try to use either the Mini Conspiracy palette, this cute,
or
this guy. I'm gonna be wearing Are You Filming on my lips, which is this beautiful freaking red. It's so pretty. I've been wearing that pretty frequently lately.
I love it.
I literally find any excuse to wear it, so.
But this palette,
I don't know why I just smelled them. For some reason, I thought they were gonna smell like root beer, but like they don't. Anyway, this palette, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? To be honest, and I hate being this person, but like I feel like the way that this palette feels better than the Conspiracy palette. The Conspiracy palette packaging is beautiful, like it really is,
but
what throws it off for me is specifically the clips. Like I don't like how they sound. Like they sound
like cheap to me. That's what throws
it off to me. But it's still a really
beautiful palette. Like it's beautiful. It's really pretty.
Another thing with eyelashes is that it's very hard to get makeup
off without getting your eyelashes wet.
So I stopped wearing eyeliner for that purpose because you can only use oil for makeup remover, and so I just choose to not wear eyeliner because it's easier that way, and I don't have all the time in the world to spend taking my makeup off and being careful when using Q-tips.
And you know,
I know I really want to go in with just a theory, this beauty right here, at some point, and I know that I'm gonna put Diet Cola like right here. Oh, with sleep paralysis too.
Ooh, oh my god.
So I'm just gonna go in with Tanacon just because it's a pretty neutral shade, and I'm just gonna so I'm going in with shade Tanacon right now, and also I love that there is a Tanacon shade. One, because that whole thing was a freaking mess. And two, I actually love Tana Mojo. Like or Tana Paul. I love her. And like, I know a lot of people don't, but like also so many people do. And I'm one of those so many people that do love her. Because
I think that at the end of the day, like, she is entertaining and she makes me laugh and she,
I'm doing such a bold lip, I'm gonna do more of a neutral eye. So I just did Tanacon. I'm now gonna go in with Diet Root Beer,
which is this shade right there. I'm gonna go in with that one.
Scratching my ear. I need to buff out my right side a little bit, so I'm gonna go in with the, of course, Morphe X Jeffree Star in JS3 and kind of
buff this out and blend it a little bit more.
I'm gonna go in with this brush. It's my Morphe. Ooh, I can still see it.
Morphe S11 brush.
And
where is my Fix Plus?
I'm gonna spray some Fix Plus on this bitch.
And then I'm gonna put Just a Theory on my lid.
I literally cried when I watched Lizzie McGuire for the first time. That show is literally my childhood. Like, oh, I cannot explain like how nostalgic and like happy that shit made me feel. Hilary Duff, like, that show obviously like introduced me to her, and I just cannot.
Like, and I still religiously follow her.
Like, she had Banks, her daughter. Banks' middle name is Violet. Guess what Violet's name is? Violet.
That's not the sole reason why,
but like, it's up there. And I just love it. Cool. Now, I was gonna put Diet Cola in like the corner, but I don't feel like that would look
good. I don't know.
I was gonna put a little bit of my rice here, which is black. I was gonna put a little bit of that
on the corners. I'm really interested to see how pigmented this.
Pigmented? How pigmented?
This
black is, and also
scared because blacks are scary.
They are. If they're super pigmented
and you go in too hard, you
got a black eye.
Can you really do to fix that besides start over? Let me know, because
I decided that for the corners, I am not going to go in with Diet Cola just because I don't feel like that's the look. But you know what I did want to try? I want to
put Sleep Paralysis,
which is this
shade right there, Sleep Paralysis.
I really want to try to put that also in like this part of my eye. Just like a little bit. So it kind of like
blends in with the black. But also adds some shimmer.
This is a very bold move for me.
Jesus.
Oh gosh, she is pretty. Okay. So for my highlight shade, I am.
And like for the corners,
I'm gonna go in with that same shade from the Morphe X Jeffree Star palette with Designer Label. I'm gonna highlight my brow bone with that, as well as the corner of my eye. I'm gonna do this with my Morphe X Jeffree Star in shade JS6.
So let me just bring that down again.
Right here, right here.
do my mascara, then I'll spray, then I will
put lipstick on, and then we'll be done, and then Marcus will start getting ready, and then we leave. Oh my god, and then we're gonna see issues.
It's like, oh,
I'm so exciting. I really like this mascara. I also feel like doing your bottom lashes is such a freaking
staple and like important part of
makeup.
Frown when you're doing
that. Alright, so I am done with that. You know what I'll do? Since I'm letting that dry before I do that, I'm gonna do my lipstick.
Now.
Oh, I can't wait for you guys to see
how pretty this is. Oh my god. This for sure smells like root beer.
So good. Alright, let's hope that I do this evenly, because sometimes my top lip does not come
even.
Doing my lipstick, I got a notification from YouTube
that
Tokyo Hotel uploaded a video. Like, didn't know they were still doing their thing,
but you know,
good for them. Okay, but like this makeup,
this lipstick gives me so much life. Like I live for it so aggressively. I'm so obsessed with it. Okay. Also, I hope a fan doesn't make a noise like that, because...
Alright. Okay. I am gonna go and put the rest of my clothes on, put my hat on. You guys can see the final look for right now, for tonight.
And I'll be right back.
Okay, here we are. This is the final look for me. I wear these glasses and they have blue light protection, so like the glare is gnar, I'm sorry. But I also noticed, I was watching back my, I'm just gonna take these off. I was watching back my video for a little bit and like, there's gnarly static and I'm so sorry. Like, I don't know why, but I'll try to fix it, like, I guess. But yeah, if this is the last time I see you guys, thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate it.
It was fun.
Bear with me through this journey just because, you know, it is
my first video and my first few videos.
And they'll get better with, you know, I'll get more equipment and everything. But yeah, thanks so much. And if it's not the last time I see you, then I'll see you shortly. Thanks.
You call it off, and I never been so mad at myself. Girl, I know she's trying to play. She's like a lot of these days.